I'm glad you're here.
I'm glad you're here.
Yeah, I'm glad everybody's here. But most of all, I'm glad God's here. I'm just glad that the Lord is here tonight. You know what? Don't tell me you wouldn't get a little bit more. It don't matter whether you like the guy or not. But if George W. Bush walked through that door back there, don't tell me you wouldn't leave out of here and go tell somebody.
Come on.
Right. And guess who was with us in church tonight?
Right.
They not voting for the rascal, but what I'm saying, but gee, if ex-President Clinton walked in here, you'd probably say the same thing. But there's somebody greater than both of them guys, and that's Jesus Christ, and he's here tonight. Somebody's got his
healing.
Yeah. Okay, visitors here tonight, welcome to an opportunity of a lifetime.
Right.
Welcome to the kingdom of God.
Right.
What is the kingdom of God? Righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. And the Holy Ghost ain't nothing to freak out over, okay? Come on now, ain't no Holy Ghost. You know what I'm talking about? It's just the Spirit of God that comes in and wants to dwell inside of you.
Right.
The Bible says like a river of living water
right. That
flows out of you.
Right.
How many likes to be happy? Come on, you got to be happy? You know, I seen a report my wife showed me the other day, and I'll let you see it in a second. But this poor old South Louisiana or somewhere in the South, that boy, the redneck, and I call them rednecks down here, I don't know what they call them, but there's nothing wrong with that, nobody get me wrong, but he won that big lottery, y'all know what I'm talking about?
Amen.
Lived in a trailer. They come up to him and ask him, well, tell me what you think about it. He never even gave an expression. Well, it's okay. He said, I'm going to buy myself a truck. I'm going to buy my wife a Lexus. And she spoke up and said, no, I want a Mercedes. And I said, don't you know Mercedes is going to run with that? They're going to probably run down an advertisement. But you know what? I told my wife, I said, about 5 years, he'll have known all that money to be right back where he is.
Right.
Friend, let me tell you, the things of the world ain't going to satisfy you, but only for a moment.
Right.
Then after that, it's gone.
Right.
One example. Don't hold it against me. But I'm an LSU Tiger.
Amen.
Right.
Go Tigers. I know Trojan man here. But I'm on your horse, son, and run off on the distance. But let me tell you something. LSU probably got more likely Trojans will have a better shot of winning the championship this year than LSU.
Yeah.
That's football.
Right.
It's here. You go to his house. Today I have an LSU shirt. I'm LSU, but let me tell you, my inner man tells me the chances that they're winning it next year are slim to none. But friend, if you're living for God, you're victorious every day of the week, every month, every year. You're sort of a winner. Tell us how a winner.
Winner.
I want to be associated with a winner. How about you?
Yeah.
How many really wants to be a winner here tonight? You get up here, what you're driving, that ain't what it's about.
Right.
What it's about is about getting the kingdom of God, loving God.
Yeah.
Because this life we live, pastors already said it, this life is nothing more than a vapor.
Amen.
Well, let's say you live to 70-something years old, and what, you're going to retire for a few years? Is that life? I hope that's not all there is to life.
Wow.
I hope there's something on the other side waiting on me. I hope there's sweet some gold. Saying, boy, tonight you're in a great opportunity to be introduced to the kingdom of God.
Right.
The kingdom of God is more than heaven. The kingdom of God is here
tonight.
And God wants to put out the welcome mat for you and say, it don't matter where you come from, what your station in life is, how much you have, how much you don't have. It's for whosoever will.
Amen.
How many's glad for the mercies and grace of God?
Amen.
How many's really glad for that? That ain't going to save you. But Jesus Christ can save you.
Amen.
How many's glad for that? Hallelujah. I want to help you tonight. Come on, look at somebody and say, he's getting ready to help you.
Now
don't overemphasize it. Just say, he's here to help you. I say, help you. Visitors, I'm glad you're here tonight. Because there's a presence of God here that wants you to know he's for you and not against you.
All right.
He wants you happy. He wants you to prosper. If there's ever a time in our existence we need to prosper, it's now.
Amen.
Market's down, economy's crashing, we're in a recession. But you know what? To God's people, God's the same yesterday, today, and forever. Yeah. First John chapter 1, and I heard this. You ever heard me preach, you're going to love me because I ain't going to keep you long. Hallelujah. Take a deep breath, relax. Amen. But I want you to get something from the Word of God tonight. The Word of God is forever settled. I don't care, pastors always say, I don't care what man says, what does the Word say?
All right.
Doesn't matter what Jeff Ferris says, what does the Word say?
That's right.
As long as I stay in the Word, everything's all right.
That's right.
But when I start getting out of the Word, he's got a right to say, okay, time out, you go sit down and let me finish.
Right. Right.
Because I want to be in the Word. Everybody say the Word.
Word.
First John chapter 1. Let's begin at verse 5. Then this is the message. Everybody say the message.
The message.
Which we have heard of him and declare to you that God is light. Everybody say God is light.
God is light.
Well, in him is no darkness at all. Everybody say there is no darkness. And we say that we have fellowship with him, and walk in darkness, we lie.
All right.
And do not know the truth.
Yes.
But if we walk in the light as he is the light, we have fellowship one with another, and the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanses us from all sin. Everybody say all sin.
All sin.
If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves.
Right.
And the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all, everybody say all, unrighteousness. If we say that we have not sinned, last verse, we make him a liar, and his word is not in us.
That's right.
You know what this all sums up to this? It's time to get the lie.
Right.
Come on, turn around with the four or five people and say, hey, turn the light on. Come on, let me check. Shake your hands now. I'm glad you're here, but you need to get the light on, man. Come on, that's it. Clap your hands under the Lord right now if you were sitting. Hallelujah. In essence, what he was saying is God is light. Somebody shout, God is light. You can be seen. God is pure light. Somebody shout, pure light.
Pure light.
There is not a trace of darkness in him. And if we claim we share life with him, and we continue to stumble around in the dark, we're obviously lying through our teeth, and we're not living the life we claim.
Come on.
I'm playing bold, isn't it? But if we walk in the light, God himself being the light, then we share life with one another.
Wow.
Think about it. You and God in the light sharing life.
Come on.
I don't know about you, but I want to be in the light of God sharing life with him.
Ourselves.
A claim like that is nonsense, for none of us is perfect.
Alright. Amen. That's right.
I ain't gonna tell you to do it, but I know some of y'all love to look at somebody next to you and say, hey, get over it. You are a long ways from me. I know that one at the church, this one guy, he kept pulling his life. And I told him, I said, hey, enough of that. We know she's not perfect, but neither are you. But aren't you glad that we have a right to come into the presence of God, even in our condition? We can walk into the light of God and share life with him. And we can walk out of here knowing that God will light our pathway, that God will be there for us. God, I miss you, Bill. But at least we fucked up. This world is as dark as it's ever been. Thank God for the light of God. Shine on me. Shine on my pathway. Clap your hands over him. The scripture says he'll be true to himself.
Amen.
And he'll forgive our sins and purge us from all wrongdoing. But if we say, hear me now, we have never sinned, then we contradict God and we make a liar out of him. And that just proves we really don't know God.
Right.
Hear me. Oh, somebody hear me tonight. But once we get the light of God in our life, once the light of God comes down upon us, then God can share life with us. And God can forgive us our sins. And God can make things right that was wrong. I don't know how that makes you feel, but that gets me excited to know that when I stumble, when I fall, there's a God standing right there.